visit is in keeping with the warm meeting of two great men, has enormously benefited both our peoples in the last four decades. The traits that cultural differences, as distinct as our own, need not separate or alienate peoples from one another. As the guardians of Mecca and the protectors of your social systems, yet with respect and goodwill, as our two countries have demonstrated, so much.
Commerce has grown, especially between our two countries. Petroleum from Saudi wells helps drive the engines of progress in the United States, while at the same moment, American technology and know-how help in the construction in which Saudi Arabia has conducted its economic affairs. King Fahd and other Saudi leaders, conscious of the global impact of their financial and economic decisions,
democracies in the Muslim world, by all that they believe to be true and just, should stand together in opposition to those who would impose dictatorship.
Iran and Iraq, a conflict that is raging only a few minutes by air from Saudi territory. And our moral suasion can, at the very least, decrease the threat of war. If the Saudi and American governments' Foci Council Resolution 242 is within reach, the security of Israel and other nations of the region and the legitimate rights of the Palestinian people.
Mr. President, since the historic meeting between His Majesty the late King Abdul Aziz Al Saud and the late President Franklin Roosevelt 40 years ago this month, the leaders of our two countries.
وكانت تطلعات الشعوب العربية متوجهة إلى الولايات المتحدة باعتبار
following the First World War to the time when the majority of the Arab countries were suffering under the States reaffirms those principles this time under your leadership, Mr. President.
فخامة الرئيس وجد نفسه دون أي ذنب ارتكبه ضحية الاعتداء الأثيم أخرجه من أرضه ودياره. إن القضية الفلسطينية تهم الأمة العربية كلها.
المشكلة اللبنانية هي انسحاب إسرائيل من الأراضي اللبنانية لكي يتحقق ضمان سيادة لبنان وسلامة الأراضي واستقلال الإسلام.
We only ask for a just position that conforms the problem of Lebanon needs to be addressed in such a way that it guarantees the withdrawal of Israel from Lebanon. And with the conclusion, Mr. President, I would like to thank you.
Thank you very much. في واشنطن. ولكن حل الفكرة موجودة بيني وبين محمد الرئيس، ولكن ما يجب أن نفكر أن حل المشكلة ممكن أن تأتي دفعة واحدة، ولكن المهم أني مسرور باللقاء مع محمد الرئيس للتباحث معه في جميع ما يهم منطقة الشرق الأوسط وما يهم مصالح المجتمع.
Of course, the confidence between myself and the President is mutual. We have to think about a solution for all the issues and the problems that confront us in that region. And I'm very happy to have this opportunity to meet with President Reagan in order to discuss all these issues that will bring the benefit to the Middle East and to our mutual interests.
Vice please. Thank you.
Step back a little bit.
February 1985, President Reagan meeting with Saudi delegation in the cabinet room, open coverage.
That's really good.
Emptying the
but it was a lot of other
pipes.
It was all sorts of other pipes.
Where's Camp over in?
He is in
England right now, actually.
He'll be back tomorrow. London.
He went to Ditchling for the weekend. Something he always likes.
What is Ditchling?
Ditchling's marvelous. You should try it.
Put in your. I can get water. I have a spring which would provides drinking water.
How do you manage that? Because we can't pump the oil out.
This system is designed to be heated by
wood alone.
Uh-huh. So it'll work fine. Now there's a circulator pump.
Flanking should be present in sort of protocol order. The flanking guys on either side of him, then the rest of the other side.
We can have simultaneous translation. Again, a welcome to you and the members of your delegation. We've touched on a few subjects, but I'd like you to know how much we admire and respect the modernized economy